Hey friends, my name is Pradyuman and welcome to my channel VMware NSX Cloud, where I'm sharing step-by-step videos which may help you in your deployment. Hence, do not forget to like and subscribe and press bell icon for all future videos notifications. In our last video in this series, we have covered deployment of edge node cluster in VMware Cloud Foundation environment. Now, it's time we create application virtual networks for hosting workloads. Let's start. Let's log into SDDC manager and validate if the bundle download which we initiated in our last video has been completed or not. We can navigate to lifecycle management and select bundle management. In previous version, if the download was complete, it used to be visible in download history, but we can filter the list with downloaded to validate if the correct binaries are available. Now let's move to workload domains and again click on three dots in front of management workload domain and select option add AVNs. Now you will be presented with a wizard. Please select overlay backed NSX segments and on the next screen choose edge cluster and tier 1 router on which your AVNs gateway will be hosted. Here two segments will be created, one for region specific workloads and one for cross region specific workloads. We need to provide network name, network, mask address and gateway along with MTU. As my deployment is nested, I am keeping MTU to 6000. However, in real world deployment, keep MTU size to 9000, which is a recommended value. Now wait for the task to complete. After successful AVN creation, it's time we start deployment of vRealize components. And in order to deploy vRealize suite, we need to deploy Lifecycle Manager. vRealize suite deployment will be done from Lifecycle Manager, that too in specific order. As you can see, LCM is a prereq. Once LCM is deployed, we can install Workspace ONE Access, vRealize Operations, Log Insight, and VRA. Click on Deploy and start LCM deployment wizard. On the first page, review and confirm all prereqs are complete. Move to next screen and review the AVN details. Provide FQDN of LCM and Tier 1 load balancer IP along with password for management. As you have provided FQDN, it will assign IP to appliance based on DNS lookup. Hence, DNS entry is very important. Now review summary and hit finish. You can monitor progress under task screen. Once all tasks are completed successfully, navigate to workload domains and select management domain. Now click on services tab, you will see newly deployed LCM is available. Now click on that LCM and verify that you are able to log in. That's it for today, friends. If you have any suggestion or feedback, please share it in the comment section and subscribe for more content like this.